What's up, YouTube? It's Mr. Clean, and welcome to the Pegasus 303 channel. This is a quick and easy tutorial to get your onboard audio working for your Hackintosh, and this is macOS 10.12 Sierra. So let's get going. Go ahead and launch your browser, and let's go to TonyMacX86.com. If you don't have an account, you'll need to create one, otherwise you won't be able to download the files. So let's go to Downloads, Community Software. And we're going to need EFI Mounter version 3. Let's go ahead and download that. And let's go back. And simply go to Downloads again. And we are going to need KextBeast 2.0.1. So let's go ahead and download that as well. Okay, we got those goodies. So now we're going to go to insanelymac.com. I'll put the link in the description. And a special shout out to Zenith432 from Sourceforge and Slice from Insanely Mac for making this possible. So let's go ahead and scroll down and let's grab this Kext right here. This is VoodooHDA 2.9.0D10. This actually has a fix. So let's go ahead and download that. And this one is different from the VoodooHDA 2.8 that's in MultiBeast. When you install that one, it may not work at all, or you may get some artifacts or noise in your headphone jack or out of the rear port. So this is actually a fix for that. And let's scroll back up and let's grab the VoodooHDA preference pane. This is an improvement on the preference pane that's installed by MultiBeast. It actually works. So let's go ahead and download that. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and quit the browser. Right. Okay, let's grab KextBeast and let's drop it right here so I have that handy. All right, really important. Let's go ahead and launch our EFI Mounter. Oops. Security. Open anyway. Open. I'm gonna quit that. Okay. Going to require your admin password. Okay, let's go ahead and mount our EFI partition. I want to show you something. EFI Clover and our Clover config plist or property list. And right here in ACPI, this is where all the goodies get patched. But our installation of MultiBeast, we didn't choose to install audio, but it actually patches the ACAL to HDEF and the HDAS to HDEF or high def. It actually patches that for you in your DSDT. So that is good. And devices, we actually didn't install audio, but our audio device will keep that one and not do anything here. I'm going to go ahead and quit this. Now, real important, this VoodooHDA.kext, this is the one that is the version 2.9 that's an improvement on the one by MultiBeast. So we did not install it previously, so we don't have to delete it and do it again. But if you did that before, there's a way that I can show you. All right, so we're gonna launch KextBeast. This is real important. Make sure you only have one Kext file on the desktop, otherwise it'll get confused and possibly mess up something. All right, click continue, continue, agree. Okay, choose your hard drive and click continue. Real important, this is system library extensions. So this is actually a hidden part of the drive, but we are not going there. So we're simply gonna go to library extensions, which is actually here if you need more of a visual, your hard drive, library extensions into this folder. But you can't simply drag and drop. You have to use KextBeast or some other sort of Kext program. Click continue. Install. Once again, enter your admin password. All right, let that run. Okay. Successful. Go ahead and move it to the trash. That's fine. Now, let's go back to hard drive, library, and let's go down to preference panes. Go ahead and open that up. And let's take our downloaded preference, our VoodooHDA preference pane, and then simply drag it to there, authenticate, into your admin password. All right, so we should be good to go. So go ahead and reboot, and let's see what happens. Rareport. All right, you should have my lav now. Let's go to System Preferences and see if we're actually getting that. Sound. Check 1, 2. All right, that is the pink rear. Go ahead and quit that. The source you're listening to right now is actually the mic input. We're going to take the stereo out. And that's going to go to our receiver. We're going to have to switch cameras over, but for now, that's going to be that. Sorry, these aren't color-coded. This one will be our rear. Our left's around, right's around. I had to grab this receiver from the other room. All right, and this will be our center sub. Okay, I'm going to use the SPDIF or optical out as well. Bear with me, going in at a weird angle there. All right. Okay, I'm going to change cameras over so I can see the receiver. And once again, I had to grab this from the other room, so this is kind of quick and dirty. It's not pretty, but functional nonetheless. It's a 5-1 setup. All right, let's grab our left and right. Let's grab our center sub. Sorry, these aren't color coded. And grab our surrounds. Once again, not color coded. Okay. Optical one. All right, that is connected. Okay, so let's grab our little MIDI thing here, applications, utilities, MIDI, audio MIDI setup. Let's go drag that to the dock. We'll probably need that again. I'm going to go ahead and launch that. Okay, this is our 5-1, our green, orange, and black coming out of the rear of the machine. So good, configure speakers. And in theory, we should have a working 5-1, but as I mentioned previously, we do not, but I showed you how to connect the cables and whatnot, and I'll do another video on the 5-1, but let's test it with a little pink noise. Just the volume output. Left. Don't have a center. That's right. That's our sub. That's your sound. What you can actually do, because at the moment, just go to 2.0. It says surround, but it's actually left, right, channels 1 and 2. And go ahead and do this. Left. Right. Okay, now let's try our SPDIF or optical out. Gray rear. And that comes up 2 volts around. It's left, right, that's fine. Okay, that was our optical, and you'll notice it's really hot. It's got a real hot signal compared to the analog out. This is the lav microphone plugged into the front port here. It says pink front, but it has no color code, but it recognizes it, so that works. And I'm going to switch over to the headphone so you can see that or hear that. And here we go. Okay, so I'm going to plug in my headphones to the headphone port here. And make sure headphones green front is selected. And let's find something to play. Okay, and I'm hearing it come out of the headphones. Let me see if I can get my mic to pick this up. So there you go. The headphones are working. You don't have a ton of gain, but the overall level is pretty decent, and there's no noise like in VoodooHDA version 2.8. So that's microphone in, front panel, microphone in, rear panel, line out, rear panel, stereo, out. 5.1, not quite working yet. I have technically a 2.0 left, right, and the sub, but I will be doing another video with a full 5.1 setup. Thanks a lot, and please remember to like and subscribe below, and if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below. Thanks. Take care.